Hi guys. So today we're gonna do a very important video that is truly a life hack. Why would you spend $15 on a haircut when you can DIY it? I don't know. So today I'm gonna show you how to give yourself a haircut. Just for a disclaimer, I have never actually cut my own hair. I don't have any experience. You guys can see how it turns out on me. And if it turns out good, then you can try it yourself. First, gather your supplies. Okay, the first thing you're gonna need is enough hair to spare in case you accidentally cut too much off. At least a foot of hair, because if your hair is to your shoulders and you mess this up, then you don't really have that much left. And then you're gonna need a quarter, because I'm just trying to get my split ends off. So I think I only want like half an inch, and a quarter is about half an inch. So I'm gonna use a quarter to measure, a pin to mark my hair. Now I have dark hair, so this probably won't work out as well, a post-it note in case you need to like stick something in your hair. So I'm just trying to make this haircut the best haircut possible. A snack in case you get hungry, because this might be a long process. You never know, it depends how much hair you have and if you mess up. So I picked for my snack a Starburst. It's cherry kiwi chew. And a mirror. Preferably a big mirror, but if all you have is a small handheld mirror, I'll show you what that looks like. This. Look. So, yeah, a mirror, a big mirror, small mirror, any type of mirror. And last, but certainly not least, scissors. Now, it's recommended that you use hair scissors, but I didn't have any hair scissors, so I had to improvise. Just get sharp scissors. And it was either this or kitchen scissors. And I mean, these look pretty sharp to me. They're kind of angled, which scares me, but we're gonna make it work. Because, I mean, if you don't have hair scissors at home, this is a DIY, as in you shouldn't have to buy anything. So, hair scissors. We're trying to save $15 here. My suggestion would be not to be nervous, because the more nervous you are, the more you'll mess up. So as long as you're calm and relaxed, it should turn out perfectly. All right, so I'm gonna take it down my hair since my hair is up, and you don't wanna do this whenever your hair is up because that can cause mistakes. Dad, stop. I think my hair is like 2 feet long. So, let's start from the back. All right, so I have my section of hair. You don't want to do this in too big of sections, just like average sections. And if you do it too small, then it'll just take forever. I mean, you can go ahead if you want, but it'll take a long time. So take the end, take the quarter, and then take the clip. Oh gosh, I think I'm gonna have to make this bigger than a quarter. I'll make it a post-it note. Okay, change of plans. We're not using the quarter or the clip. We're using the post-it note. Okay, now I'm gonna stick the post-it note on my ends, and I'm gonna make sure it touches the bottom. This is about like an inch. And then I'm just gonna, oh, this is a lot. I don't know, this is kind of scary. I can do this. All right. Oh my gosh, I don't know. Maybe let's start from the front. Yeah, Okay, so I got my little ish section of hair, and then got my post-it note, and I'm just gonna cut it off. It's gonna be okay. Okay. Ready? Okay, here's my hair. It's the size of the post-it note. Okay, I mean, that went well. Oh gosh, I feel like that's a lot. And I cut it like at an angle. I don't think you're supposed to cut it at an angle. Hold on, let me show you. This is why I said you need to have spare hair. Okay, let me find it. All right, it's right there. I don't know. I feel like this is gonna look bad. But we're gonna keep going. You're gonna need a lot of post-it notes for this. Like for all your sections of hair. Oh, and you should probably remember which section you just cut off so then you don't cut it again. Which, yeah, I think that's about my section. Okay. And then you're just gonna keep doing this till you get to the end of your hair. It's gonna turn out great. We're really excited, right? You know what? The post-it note thing is really time consuming. So I think I'm just gonna like measure it how I think it's supposed to be. And then I'll just show you guys it at the end. My mom will be so mad if she walks in here. All right, time for the second half. Yeah, honestly, just like looking at it is a lot easier than the post-it note method. I'm not suggesting the post-it note method anymore or the quarter method. You should just do whatever you feel is right. It's looking pretty even. Fantastic job. Okay, and then you're gonna look in the mirror and make sure everything's even, and even the back. So I'm gonna take this little mirror and then see if I can see the back of it. I did miss a couple pieces, so that's why you have to double check. And my hair's a lot shorter than before. I think I cut about like 2 inches off, and I just wanted half an inch, so that's a little bit disappointing. But even the ends of my hair are soft now, so I think I'm pretty happy with how this turned out. And I definitely suggest this way to cut your hair, and it looks just as good, if not better, than what a hair salon could do. This is the better alternative from going to get your hair cut. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed it. You're welcome. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. I hope you try this at home, and if you do, then let me know how it turned out for you. For me, it turned out well, as we know, so I hope the same effect happens to you. Bye, guys.